And what I suggest is fairly outlandish, so I do not expect everyone to understand this. Except for the kids that know how it feels like they're worth no more than the D or the A that they get on a results day. And the ones whose best stories were never good enough for your English teacher. Because apparently you missed out key literal techniques. Do not follow the class plan, and the language was too informal for him to understand. But then you reference Hamlet and Macbeth, and you fight the urge to express your contempt by partially clenching your fist with only your medium finger left protruding in the middle of your hand, and asking if he was aware that Shakespeare was known as the innovator of slang. Or the kid at the back of the class who thinks, why am I studying something that doesn't fuel my drive? But when confronted with a math problem, his eyes come alive. So this one is for my generation, the ones who found that what they were looking for on Google, the ones who followed their dreams on Twitter, pictured their future on Instagram, accepted destiny on Facebook. This one's for my failures and my dropouts, for my unemployed graduates, my shop assistants, cleaners, and cashiers with bigger dreams, my self-employed entrepreneurs, my world changers, and my dream chasers. Because the purpose of why I hate school but love education was not to initiate a worldwide debate, but to let them know that whether 72 or 88, 44 or 68, we will not let exam results decide our fate. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Noel Austin for DNAS.